Okay, let's look at these. So here I've drawn a chunk of memory, and we're going to say that G points into this memory. So this is G sub 0, G sub 1, G sub 2, and so forth. And here's a bunch of threads. And we're just going to reason out where each of these threads is accessing in memory. So in the first case, G sub I equals A. Well, every thread is simply accessing a location in memory defined by its thread index. This is exactly the example we've been talking about. A given set of threads will be accessing a bunch of adjacent contiguous locations in memory. So this case is clearly coalesced. In this case, every thread is accessing a location in memory defined by its index times 2. And so there's going to be a strided access here, right? Threads are going to end up reading every other location in memory. So this is the access pattern we've called strided. It's not coalesced. This next access pattern is exactly like the first time, except that we're doing reads instead of writes. So again, every thread is simply reading a location defined by its own index in memory. Therefore, adjacent threads will access adjacent locations in memory. And just like the first example, we're going to have a nice coalesced access pattern. This next example is coalesced because every thread is reading from a location defined by G plus some offset, block width over 2, plus the thread's index. So if this is block width number 2, then every thread will be accessing adjacent locations starting at that offset. So this is coalesced. And this example is simply the same pattern. We're going to read from this location, which is defined by an offset plus the thread index. We're going to multiply it times a constant, and we're going to store the result back into a contiguous chunk of memory. So this is simply a coalesced read followed by a coalesced write. Therefore, the statement is coalesced. And finally, this example is a little different. Here we're going to be accessing a location offset in memory minus the thread index. So thread 0 will access block width over 2, thread 1 will access block width over 2 minus 1, thread 2 will access block width over 2 minus 2, and so forth. And as you can see, even though we're doing the subtraction here instead of an addition, we're still accessing a contiguous region in memory. Every thread is accessing adjacent locations in a contiguous chunk of memory, so this is still coalesced.